Hello, my name is Johan Venter, and I just turned my Moodle site into an attractive marketing platform. I thought you may like to know how I did that. I started off with a clean Moodle 4.0 installation on a hosted server. I used the ordinary boost theme and started creating some courses. I soon realized that this will not appeal to my audience because they would like something with more pizzazz. In the earlier versions of my Moodle site, I used the Fortson theme. It was quite attractive, but unfortunately does not work for the Moodle 4.0 version and later. So I started searching for something suitable and discovered the Academi theme. As administrator, go to Plugins and choose to download plugins from the Moodle Plugins directory. Log into your free Moodle.org account. You can also choose to download the theme and install it as a zip file package. Themes that have been created by others are available at the Moodle.org site. Some are complicated to set up and others less so. I found the Academi plugin suitable for my limited level of expertise. Because my site is registered with Moodle.org, Moodle knows that I have the right version for this site to install the plugin. After doing some checks on my server, Moodle advised me that it was okay to proceed with the installation and to upgrade my database. That sounded scary, but since I had backups of everything, I felt confident to proceed. Having installed the theme, I had to activate it by going to the theme selector at Appearances, Themes, Theme Selector. Now I'm using the Boost theme, but I can change to the Academi theme by clicking on Change Theme and Use Theme. Please note that you can activate the theme for various types of devices. I think it is important that users should have a similar experience of the site regardless of what device they use. So I selected the theme for all types of devices, including smartphones. Here you can see that I have activated the theme for three kinds of devices. Once your Academi theme is up and running, you can set it up by going to Site Administration, Appearance, Theme, and Academi. There are seven areas that you have settings for. I'll first give a short summary of what they all mean and then show you how I change the settings for each. Some general settings that we will look at shortly. The home page slider, that is the most prominent feature of the theme. This is where your site can really make big announcements about your brand, service, and products. The promoted courses block shows images of your important offerings, those site features that you are so proud of, the marketing spot where you should promote your brand or image. The Jumbotron gives more marketing opportunity and a button to connect your audience with your resources. The footer that may contain some further announcements as well as social media links. The footer is the only block that shows on all pages when someone uses your site. Let's go through some of the specifics of the settings that I used. First, go to the general settings and give your site some visual appeal. Marketing always uses logos. I created mine in PowerPoint and saved it as a .png file here. I made it so that it would stand out on a darker background. That is why my file preview contains a white image, invisible in the preview. The favicon distinguishes a professional site from others. It is this icon one sees in the browser tab. This is also a .png image created in PowerPoint. The primary color of your brand will be prominent at the head of each page and elsewhere. The secondary color needs to contrast with the primary or complement it, but it should be different. I left all the other settings at the default level, except for the login page background image. I used a washed out version of the image I will use later as a background for the footer. Click Save Changes whenever you have changed some settings. The homepage or front page slideshow should really announce your site loud and clear to your audience. I found 3 royalty-free images of friendly people studying and collaborating on their devices. Each slide can also have promotional content in text overlays. The really great thing is that each text overlay can also contain a button with which you can direct traffic to your other resources. I have limited myself to only 3 slide pages, but will definitely increase it to its full potential of 12 slides soon. The settings are self-explanatory. I found the autoplay worked well, but I couldn't adjust the pause time. Activating the slide contents shows this text overlay over the slide. Enter the text for each overlay. Don't forget text and a URL for each button. Your Moodle site probably has some courses that you would like to promote. I also use the opportunity to welcome visitors and to explain how the site works. By specifying the course ID number, the course and its image is displayed. I'm only promoting one at the moment, but the number you can seem endless. Commas separate each course's ID. The course ID is seen here when a course is launched. Your site, no doubt, some features that you are proud of. This is where you announce them and make your settings to show them off. Each feature needs a title and a description. One may choose up to 4 features. I didn't change the icons suggested by Academi. The marketing spot gives the opportunity to post some text descriptions of you, your product or service. Note that the text may contain links to other resources. You can include a picture of yourself or your product. The Jumbotron is yet a further opportunity for marketing. It needs a title and description. The Jumbotron gives you the added feature of a button that you can link to your product or service that you are offering in addition to your courses. The footer is the only part of your site that will always be visible whenever someone visits your site or takes one of your courses. The footer background image and text overlays are very important feature to keep your audience informed. It also gives the opportunity for copyright and other legal notices. The footer is divided into 4 sections or blocks. I activated all 4, but only used 3. It feels less cramped that way. An important aspect of marketing is social media following. Footer block 4 allows 8 social media links, of which I used 4. Something that the Academi setting didn't allow me to set was the logo used in the login screen. By going to Appearance and Logos, I was able to upload a .png file that contained my site logo. Again, it was created in PowerPoint and made to look consistent with other images used in the theme. Remember, effective online marketing is a careful blend of self-promotion, product promotion, and free and useful information that your audience will want to come back for more and more. I've probably not given enough of the latter, but as this site that was made possible by Academi grows, I'll give more of it.